What is going on, champions? It has been a long time. Give y'all some time to come on in here. Just getting into my mode, listening to my brother's new edition. It's been a long time coming. If you hopped on, feel free to type in the chat box. Let me know who's all on. Let me turn this music down. What's up, sis? I turn the music off. Let me know if you can hear me. It's technology for you. Hey, what's up, C? What's going on? Yeah, you get it in. I see you. Congrats on your progress so far. See what is going on. How's you all day been? No doubt, no doubt. One day at a time, one day at a time. That consistency is paying off. All right, we're going to get going because I'm not going to be all night. And quite frankly, this is something that's long overdue. And I'm just going to, let me be the first to say, welcome. Welcome to something that has been on my heart for a long time. And people have been clamoring for it. People have been asking me to do this. And I just kind of been putting it off, putting it off, putting it off, putting it off. And now it's time to get it going. And so I want to officially welcome you to what I like to call the Motivation to Elevation podcast. And so this is the first one. So you're tuning in and I appreciate it. Those that are taking time out of their schedule to find out what is going on. And for those that are new, for those who are watching me for the first time, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Arian Tyson, and I am a proud native of St. Louis, Missouri. What's up, cuz? And basically, this is something that's been on my heart for a long time. And people online know me as the Moving Motivator because I like to speak positivity. I like to speak life. And so, because we live in a world that's full of negativity and the images that we see is all negative, when you come around me or come into my space or in my area, you're going to get positivity, you're going to get encouragement, you're going to get inspiration, but you're also going to be challenged because you can't always listen to everything that you hear and take it at face value. So I would challenge you to basically do your research on any and everything, because a lot of times there's a lot of false information that's being put out here, especially on social media. And so do your due diligence. And because of that false information that's being put out here, that's why a lot of things are jacked up. So let me get this out of the way. Basically, what's going to happen is from after this particular Facebook Live, every podcast that I do going forward is going to be on my Facebook fan page. And if you haven't liked it already, make sure after we end this that you go to facebook.com/Arian Tyson. Facebook.com/Arian Tyson. That's my That's my Facebook fan page. And so that's where all of the podcasts are going to be done going forward. But having said all that, I want to talk to you today about a topic that's very, very sensitive. It's very sensitive to me, and it's probably sensitive to a whole lot of people that's going through or in the midst of a struggle, because oftentimes we go through stuff and we don't talk to people about it because we feel ashamed. We feel like we're going to be judged. But those people that know me, those friends and family that know me, know I'm not in the business of judging people. I believe in authenticity. I believe in transparency. And so for this particular podcast, and it won't be long because this is the first one, and I guarantee you I'm going to keep them coming. I'm back with a vengeance, and I'm back because I'm hungry, because I'm tired of seeing people hurting. I'm tired of hurting. And so what I'm going to do is take my pain and transform it into power. I'm going to say that again. I'm going to take my pain and I'm going to transfer it into power. Transform it into power. Because we got to get liberated. We have to. We have to be willing to understand that where we are right now is just simply where we are right now. And it doesn't dictate that this is going to be the end. And so what I want to talk about is there are a lot of people walking around with a lot of grudges, holding a lot of grudges towards people. And the crazy thing is, they don't even know that a person has a grudge against them. So what I want to talk about is forgiveness. And the question that I have is forgiveness overrated or underrated? So that's what we're going to talk about briefly. And here's basically what I've discovered. Forgiveness is a very sensitive subject for most people. Ask yourself, have you ever forgiven someone, or have you ever had to ask to be forgiven? Have you ever had to ask for forgiveness? The reality is that we all at some point or one another have been hurt or have hurt someone, whether we've been hurt by our families, whether we've been hurt by our jobs, whether we've been hurt by various businesses if we're entrepreneurs, whether we've been hurt by our spouses or in relationships, or whether we even been hurt by the church. So no one is immune to the trials and tribulations of life. But it has led me to ask this question, especially this year. Is forgiveness overrated or underrated? Should you forgive and forget something that has hurt you? That's the question that I'm asking. Because it is not easy as it seems, but it is necessary in order to grow. Everything we deal with in life is either a blessing or a lesson. This is the reason why it is often said that forgiveness is not just for the other person, it's for you. And so if you are watching this, please feel free to share this on your Facebook walls. Feel free to share this on YouTube, etc. Because I truly appreciate it. My brother Sean just shared it. So appreciate it. I see you. See you, bro. Thank you. Appreciate it. And so behind the mask, the foundation and the mental mascara that we wear sometimes are scars that have not been properly healed. And there are signs that we often ignore. With that being said, I want to share with you tonight three reasons based on my own experience why forgiveness is actually underrated. And I'm going to give you three reasons. And if you're watching this, if you're keeping up, you got a pen and paper, write it down. If not, you can watch the replay and get these three. But these are things that I've learned from my own experience. Number one, you must forgive others, not because they deserve forgiveness, but because you deserve peace. I'm going to say that again. You must forgive others, not because they deserve forgiveness, but because you deserve peace. When we come into this world, We have no concept of pain, deceit, or betrayal. If I would have chosen to hold on to the pain of going through an annulled marriage 5 years ago, I would not have been receptive to the love of another woman years later. Because I believe in being transparent. You know, we all go through stuff. We all have, you know, some things that have happened to us that we're not proud of. But nevertheless, it builds us, it teaches us, and it serves as to grow us as we mature and evolve. But when we live with unforgiveness, we retain these feelings as we navigate through all aspects of life, and they build up over time. And if we fail to go within and clear our energy and our bodies of these toxic thoughts, holding grudges can literally make us feel physically, mentally, and even spiritually ill. It causes dis-ease of the mind, which can then breed physical diseases as well. Now, how many of you all know someone that suffers from heart issues, various health issues, cognitive issues, etc.? A lot of that stuff is because they're holding on and trying to suppress pain that they have not dealt with properly. And this is not something that I read in a book. This is something that I have observed for myself. Why? Because I have actually lost family members who did not know how to let go of grudges, who did not know how to forgive, and they took their unforgiveness to their grave. So I'm not telling you something that I heard. I'm telling you what I experienced. And it is a dangerous game when you live with unforgiveness. That's something that you have to take care of. You have to. And I agree, yes, the hardest thing is to forgive someone that's not even sorry. It is. I'm a witness to it. Nevertheless, again, forgiveness is not just for the other person. It is for you. Because as they're going about their life, they're not really thinking two cents about you. They don't care. So at the end of the day, when you don't let go of stuff, you give that person and that situation power over you. And you allow it to dictate your mood, and how you go about your life. Forgiveness is absolutely a requirement. That is not up for discussion. It is mandatory. It is necessary. Because if you don't, you have nobody to blame but yourself, because at the end of the day, people are going to get tired of you singing the same old song. They're going to get tired of hearing you saying the same old thing. You don't know what they did to me. I can't believe they did that. That gets old after a while. You got to. You have to understand this. And it's not easy, but it's worth it. And also realize this. If we're honest with ourselves, holding grudges is something we really don't have no time for. How many times have you had to bury somebody that is young? You know, people ain't dying at old age no more. I mean, I've seen people, I've had to bury family members that were infants, that were 7, 13, 16, 19, 21, etc. They lost their life before they actually start living life. And a lot of times we find ourselves existing when we really think we're living. And that's something we got to understand, because just because you get up every day and you maybe go to a job that you just barely tolerate does not mean that you're living. It means that you're existing. We were not designed to just get up and pay bills. And some of us don't even do that right. So we were designed with a purpose, and that purpose we have to be unapologetic about the purpose that we are striving for. Because if you have no goals, if you have no vision, no plan, no purpose, you're kidding yourself and you're wasting time. Time can be a great commodity, but it can also be our worst enemy. next to ourselves. So that's something we got to take care of. So that's point number one. Point number two, forgiveness does not excuse their behavior. It prevents their behavior from destroying your heart. I'm going to say that again. The second reason is forgiveness does not excuse their behavior, but it prevents their behavior from destroying your heart. This one is real for me. It's real for me. Some people know what I'm talking about. Some people know what I'm talking about. Some people know what I'm referring to. And it makes me think of my father. Now, for those that don't know, my father passed suddenly on February 17th of this year. So as the holidays are coming up, this is really a tough time for me because these will be my first holidays without my dad. My dad was my hero. And I often think about something when I think about how forgiveness does not excuse their behavior. It prevents their behavior from destroying your heart. One of the verses, one of the songs that have always been dear to me, and it was even a song that I found out my dad liked, is Will Smith's version of Just the Two of Us. In the last verse of that song, if you remember, it is the song where he did the video with his oldest son, Trey, but it was his oldest, it was his only son at the time because it was right after him and his ex-wife divorced and he was dating Jada Pinkett Smith and she was pregnant with her first child by him, which actually would be Jaden. And so in the video, that last verse, he basically imparted wisdom to his oldest son, Trey, when it came to the pain of being hurt by, in this case, a member of the opposite sex. And so what he said was, and I just remember it because I've internalized it and it's helped me get through bad relationships. But it reminded me, he said, but yo, ain't nothing promised. One day I'll be gone. Feel the strife, but trust life does go on. But just in case, it's my place to impart. One day some girl's gonna break your heart. And ooh, ain't no pain like from the opposite sex. Gonna hurt bad, but don't take it out on the next, son. Throughout life, people will make you mad. Disrespect you and treat you bad. Let God deal with the things they do, because hate in your heart will consume you too. When we are hurt by someone, or when someone hurts us, we may begin to question ourselves, especially when we are hurt more than once. The worst thing we can do is carry unhealed hurt into something new. We may find ourselves, without knowing, establishing unrealistic expectations, and when someone errs, we question them. We question the relationship. All over one error. Some people call it overreacting, while others refer to it as making a mountain out of a molehill. We got to be careful about that. And I was guilty of it once upon a time. You probably have been guilty of it. You're probably guilty of it now. Or you probably know somebody that's guilty of it. So that's definitely something we got to take care of. We got to really pay attention to. And then finally, the third reason is forgiveness does not change the past, but it does enlarge the future. I'm going to say it again. Forgiveness does not change the past, but it does enlarge the future. The bitterest tears shed over graves are for words left unsaid and deeds left undone. I'm going to say that once more. The bitterest tears shed over graves are for words left unsaid and deeds left undone. Don't correct other people's opinions about you. They aren't describing you. This is what I've found out. They are trying to cope with the parts of you that they resent about themselves. For example, when someone puts you down for your number of sexual partners, and you know, we grown. I'm gonna just I'm honest, you know, we're grown. When someone puts you down for the number of sexual partners you have, they may just be resentful that they didn't go out and experience more. When they snarl at your profession, it could be that they weren't afforded the opportunity to live out their dreams. And so they resent being stuck with the job they hate. Don't come out of character when someone's opinion of you feels unfair. Because guess what? It is unfair. What's actually happening is that there's something about your greatness that reminds them of what they fear. It reminds them of what they fail at obtaining for themselves. Their opinion of you is their sounding board. It's their verbal mirror. Oftentimes, I think about a song that my granny used to sing. She used to say, I'm too close to the mirror to see what God sees. Sometimes we could be on the mirror like this, but we can't really see anything. It's not until we step back and really see the bigger picture. And we must also realize that getting another person to change his or her actions, behavior, or words isn't the point of forgiveness, y'all. Think of forgiveness more about how it can change your life by bringing you peace, by bringing you happiness, by bringing you emotional and spiritual healing. Forgiveness can take the power, can take away the power the other person continues to wield in your life. We must remember this. We are to forgive so that we may enjoy God's goodness without feeling the weight of anger burning deep within our hearts. Forgiveness does not mean that we recant the fact of what happened to us was wrong, but instead, we roll our burdens to God and allow Him to carry them for us. And so that those are the three things that I wanted to share. And so just to recap, three reasons why forgiveness is underrated instead of overrated. Number one, you must forgive others, not because they deserve forgiveness, but because you deserve peace. Number two, forgiveness does not excuse their behavior. It prevents their behavior from destroying your heart. And number three, forgiveness does not change the past, but it does enlarge the future. And so with that being said, I'm going to call this basically an end. I didn't want it to be too long. And so going forward, you'll be able to expect these podcasts to basically be about 25, no more than 30 minutes. We're just going to keep it consistent because we're going to dive into some things. I'm going to challenge you on some things. Why I challenge myself? I'm going to encourage you why I encourage myself. Because this has been a nightmare of a year, but nevertheless, even with the pain that I deal with right now, it does not mean that I'm not going to allow it to stop me from doing what I love to do. And that's speaking life into people and helping them become the best version of themselves, because people are tired of being beat down. People are tired of being, you know, overlooked, unappreciated, etc. And we have an opportunity to help one another. We got to be transparent. We got to be honest with others, and we got to be honest with ourselves, first of all, because if God brought us to that situation, He sure enough can bring us through that situation. So with that being said, I appreciate each and every last one of you all that have jumped on, taking time out of your schedule, dealing with me for these 25 or so minutes. And if you got value from this, feel free to share this with someone. Put it on your Facebook walls, etc. I'm going to post it on YouTube, and then be on the lookout because my website will be launching this week, and it will be www.motivation2elevation.com. That will be my website for this podcast, and it's going to have a blog attached to it. And so with that being said, you know, I'm not going to harbor in the past. I'm going to learn from the past, even in the midst of it. I'm not going to even wait for me to come out of the storm. I'm going to start doing what I love to do in the midst of the storm. And that way, I know that I can be a blessing to others because someone blessed me. You know, God blessed me with this gift. I don't take it for granted. And so I'm just going to give back and speak in life into other people because someone spoke life into me. The reason that I'm still here, the reason that I'm still standing in the midst of everything that's happened to me is because somebody spoke life into me. Somebody prayed for me. Some people are still praying for me. And I appreciate it from the bottom of my heart. And so with that being said, I'm going to call it a night. God bless you all. And I will see you all next week at this same time, 9:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 8:30 Central, for another episode of the Motivation to Elevation podcast. God bless y'all. Good night.